Brandon Bernard, who was 18 when he took part in a 1999 double murder in Texas, died by lethal injection in a federal prison Thursday evening, despite 11th-hour attempts for court intervention. The case drew renewed interest in recent weeks and sparked debate over whether the death penalty is a necessary punishment for someone who was barely a legal adult at the time of the crime. Now 40, he was the youngest person, based on his age when the offense occurred, in nearly 7 decades to be executed by the federal government. Less than 3 hours before the scheduled time of execution, a federal appeals court that includes Indiana denied an emergency request from Bernard's lawyers to halt it. Around 8:30 p.m. local time, the U.S. Supreme Court denied his request. The Associated Press reported his time of death about an hour later. Tonight, those of us who love Brandon Bernard, and we are many, are full of righteous anger and deep sadness at the actions of the federal government in taking his life. Brandon's life mattered to us, his legal team, to his two beautiful and talented daughters, to his mother, brother, and sister, and to the countless people around the country who came to know him and his story in recent weeks, Bernard's attorney Robert C. Owen said Thursday night. Bernard is the 9th person put to death by the federal government this year after the Department of Justice resumed executions in July after a 17-year hiatus on the federal level. This year, fear over the spread of the coronavirus in prisons has largely led states to put a hold on executions. But the surging number of COVID-19 cases and deaths in recent months have not deterred the federal government from acting in the final weeks of Donald Trump's presidency.
To do things for myself, when you try to do things for others, to try to appease others, it's not natural. And I feel like I've learned that these improvements I need to do for myself, so then they hold and they stand through the test of time.